Typically, we see two types of wasps around schools and homes, the European paper wasp and the Western yellowjacket. According to the American College of Allergy, Asthma, and Immunology, more than 2 million Americans are allergic to stinging insects.
So how do you tell the difference between them in the field? There are probably three or four main things that I would look for. The European paper wasp and the Western yellow jacket look similar in terms of their coloration, the general size. Yellow jackets are a little smaller than the European paper wasp. Legs of the European paper wasp are longer, and so in flight, those legs dangle underneath, and you can see that pretty readily. Versus the Western yellow jacket, it has shorter legs. As far as the anatomy goes, would be the shape of the abdomen. For the yellow jacket, starting at the stinger end, it sort of tapers up and gets wider and wider, and then right before it reaches the middle part of the insect, it kind of just bluntly ends like that. Versus the paper wasp, so starting again at the stinger end, it would just kind of slowly expand and widen, and then it comes gradually back down together toward the petiole, or that thin area between the thorax and the abdomen.
Paper wasps are sometimes mistaken for yellow jackets. This fact sheet will help you determine which is which.
All three of the different typical wasp species nest in different locations. The typical European paper wasp has an open nest, so when you look at it, you can see the individual cells inside. And it's usually in up, out-of-the-way places, so it could be under the eave of a house, a restroom on a playground, underneath the slide on a playground, or if the play structure has some sort of roof-like structure on it, it would be up inside that area is where you would see it. The Western yellowjacket is a below-ground species, and so you would typically find it up against a crack of concrete with a burrowing hole going down inside an old rodent burrow. So if there's prairie dogs that are near a park area or something like that, they could be down in an old prairie dog burrow. They also will nest within wall voids, but they like typically out-of-the-way places.
As you can see, it takes a keen eye to discern the differences between the European paper wasp and the yellow jacket.